Andy. They chased Marshall around a lot, and like he didn't have a lot of early success, but hit a couple of big shots late. Can you talk about his game?
Yeah, you know, again, the Marshall Henderson phenomenon. I've never seen a guy go 4 for 15 and be the lead question. But he is. That's what he is. And, you know, as his coach, the thing that I was the most pleased of, he only turned it over once. He had 3 assists. He's sharing the ball better. And 6 big rebounds. I thought he was very active for us defensively. And, you know, there was a moment where they're fighting back. It's a one-possession game. We couldn't get stops in the second half. Couldn't get stops at one time. As I looked at the sheet, they were shooting close to 58% in the second half on the field. We, as I look at the final, they shoot 45%. So obviously we were able to get some stops down the stretch. But as it was in that one or two possession mode, you know, off a loose ball, AJ's energy was fantastic. He had 8 offensive rebounds, keeps things alive, threw it out to Marshall. A lot of people think there's no way he's going to shoot that, but that's what he does. And knocked down one and then came right back and hit another one. And ultimately, I think that took the wind out of ourselves.
2 straight road games. How does that help you looking ahead in the SEC standings?
Just one at a time for us. You know, we had opportunities. It's never easy on the road. And for us to win 2 of our first 3 shows that this team's maturing. Every game is close for us. Every game is hard. We've got to embrace hard. And I think our kids are starting to do a better job of that.
What did you see in your guys in the huddle, Andy, after they lost a 13-point lead, even then trailing, to turn around and come back and finish strong like that? What did you see in them in the huddle?
Our guys have been there. You know, 12 of our 17 games coming into tonight have been a one-possession game with 90 seconds to play. So we've been in this before. We know where we want to go with the ball at the end. Thing that I was the most pleased of, when you hold a Vanderbilt team in this building 52 points, I thought we did a pretty good job of executing our scouting report and staying attached to their shooters. 9 turnovers was huge for us, with us only committing 9. We don't lose many when we stay in single digits, and then see Kevin. And then 14 steals, it just shows we were active defensively.
Did you think that first half was one of the best defensively this year?
I think so. I think they had a hard time finding rhythm. You know, they're a team that likes to get up and down the floor, especially at home. It's the reason we were trying to give them different looks defensively. Sometimes it was 1-3-1, sometimes it was 2-2-1. We mixed in some man in there simply because of our respect for Kyle Fuller's speed with the ball. We knew if he got past that initial line, he was going to break us down and get shooter shots. So we tried to do a good job of gapping him and keeping him in front of us.
What was the plan against Odom? Was it to just stop Fuller and kind of contain him more?
No, we tried. I mean, we made about 4 mistakes on Odom, and he made us pay every time. And then, you know, he's a senior playing with a senior sense of urgency. I thought he made some difficult shots in the second half where our defense wasn't so bad. He's a 6'9 guy who can shoot it from deep. And we left him a couple times. He made his pay.
Your team's scoring was spread around a little bit more. You know, when Marshall wasn't scoring, a lot of people were.
I thought Jarvis was very consistent, made some hard plays. I thought Anthony Perez had a couple of very hard drives. You know, it was. We were probably 32, 33 minutes into the game before we got to the foul line. Mm-hmm. And so we had to come to the realization that if we were going to win the game, we had to finish through some contact. I thought we did a better job down the stretch.
The defense, particularly in the first half, the post defense, looked like y'all, after a few minutes, started to take away that lob and made it harder for them to get it inside and then guarded them pretty good when they did.
Yeah, we made a couple of mistakes on Damon Jones. He's a freshman, but he's really long. And when he got us close to the basket, we had a hard time of keeping him away. Made a couple of mistakes, just not being in the right position. But overall, again, when you hold Vandy under 38% and 52 points, we out-rebounded and turned him over 17 times. Defensively, it was a very, very solid effort from us. Thank you.